Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
Praise God.
Thank God for being here on this morning. Yes. Give him all the glory, all the honor. Yes. 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 He is certainly worthy to be praised. Amen. We honor Pastor Cole and we honor all of you that are here on this morning. You know, Living Word is home, yeah. And I appreciate you, Living Word. Yeah. Amen. Let's give Living Word. Yeah. And I kind of do things a little different. I like to thank God for my family and friends in the beginning, because sometimes family and friends have to leave. So at this time, Pastor Cole, if you don't mind, I would just like to thank God for my family being here and ask them to stand, please.
Amen.
My friends and Anthony's friends, and I would like to ask you to stand at this time. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Amen.
Let us pray. God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for your presence already, dear God. We thank you, God, for loving us, for keeping us, for protecting us. We ask, dear God, that you will have your way in this service this morning. Have your way in me, dear God, as I break the word in the name of Jesus. And we will be careful to give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Is there a word from the Lord? Yes, there is. Amen. Let us go to the word. 1 Samuel chapter 16 and verse 7. 1 Samuel 16, verse 7. When you get it, just say amen for it.
Amen.
chapter 16, verse 7. That's the Old Testament. Amen.
Amen.
But the Lord said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For the Lord seeth not as man seeth, for man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart. The man looketh on the outward appearance, but the Lord looketh on the heart. In keeping with our theme this morning for this Women's Day, thank you, sister, for that definition of how the Women's Day came forth. In keeping with our theme, mold me and make me, we're going to talk for just a little while, women, on how we wish and how we pray and how we believe this morning for God to mold us and to make us. Amen?
Amen.
Mold me and make me. In 2008, we elected the first African-American president of the United States of America, President Barack Obama. President Obama's theme was change. It's time for a change. We can make a change, and we will change. Well, some changes have been made. Some we have agreed with, and some we disagreed with. Amen?
Amen.
When a new leader comes on the scene, there will always be some changes. Mm-hmm. Here in the text, we find out that a change was about to take place. Mm-hmm. Samuel had gone to Jesse's house to anoint a new king. Mm-hmm. Why? Because the present king had become rebellious and stubborn, and God was sorry that he had ever made Saul king.
Come on down.
So it was time for a change, an awesome change. We see that Samuel looked at Jesse's son Elijah, and thought, surely this is the Lord's anointed. But the Lord told Samuel, don't judge him by his appearance, because I have rejected him. People judge by appearance. But God said, I look at the heart. When God molds us and makes us, he cannot refuse to bless us. He cannot reject us as he did Elijah, Jesse's son. Why can't he do this, people? Why can't he do this, women? Because he has chosen us. The word of God says that he will bless us, and he will bless us indeed.
Yes, sir.
We see that later on, when King David was anointed, the scripture tells us that on that day, the power of God was full in King David's life. When we tell God to mold me and make me, there has to be a change to take place. From the inside out, there has to be an inner change, a change that takes place from the heart. Are you ready for a spiritual makeover this morning, women? Hallelujah! Are you ready for a spiritual makeover? But now is the time. You have an awesome audience this morning. An awesome audience. The building is full to its capacity. It's filled with God and his holy angels. Y'all remember those days, some of us older parents, when the children played with Play-Doh And they made a mess all around the house. You know, he had clay everywhere. And what would we tell the children? Clean up that mess. Get this clay from all that over this house. Clean up the mess. Well, guess what? That's what God is saying this morning. I want to clean up your mess. You are the clay. Let me clean up the mess that you made. And can't nobody clean up a mess but God. In the name of Jesus. Because I tell you, saints, we can make some messes sometimes. But God says, I can bless that mess. And turn that thing around. Hallelujah. And ask God to mold you and make you the way he would have you to be. God has given us the Holy Spirit. The water called the Holy Spirit. The Comforter. So we will not break and fall apart. If it had not been for the Holy Spirit, Shanice, the Comforter, we all would have broken and fallen apart. But thank God, hallelujah, that whatever comes our way, he's ready to mold us and he's ready to make us. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. We have to tell God, mold me and make me. So that I will be able to handle anything that comes my way. Anything that comes my way. Nothing is too big or too small for God to work out. When the potter is working on the clay, it has to be perfectly centered. It has to be perfectly centered in that wheel, in the middle of the wheel. Y'all heard that that's what they call Jesus. They say he's a wheel in the middle of a wheel. Well, we have to be totally surrendered. Jesus has to be the center of our heart. He has to be the center of our attraction. Hallelujah. If anyone else is controlling your life other than God, you ought to let them go because they're not the center. No matter the God system, we ought to be controlling our life.
Yes, yes.
Didn't hold very many people. but the presence of God was
yes.
there.
Bless
then God moved you to another level over here on Tresiden,
yes.
in a larger building, a nicer building, and the presence of God is still here. Stretch my hands God to mold you. Are you ready for God to make you?
Yes.
It's all been paid for. Jesus Christ died on the cross over 2,000 years ago just for that change, just to make us and just to mold us. But guess what? He didn't stay on the cross. He got up. Hallelujah. People of God, he got up. Thank you, God. At this time, I'm going to ask that my sister will come up and sing for us as the door of the church is open. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.